Make me yell at you because you don't listen to me the first time.
That's going to pool.
Not till I get there.
I'll watch.
Yeah, who'll watch you? Come on, you guys, give me a hand. Jenny, please take your own dance bag. I told you before we left, turn the television off.
For what? I told you, for the college musical.
What musical is that, Princess?
Honestly, sometimes I don't think you and Mother hear a thing I say.
Back these potatoes, will you, dear?
Right, Margaret.
The guard pulls. First man through takes the linebacker. Second man through takes the ball. Got it?
Got it.
Get it.
Got it.
Okay, I'm going to explain this one more time. The towel is for drying your hands after the dirt goes in the sink. Got it?
Got it.
Got it.
Good.
Go! Go! Hold it! Hot loaf of bread, Terry. Go! Huddle! Hello!
Okay, guys, same play. On three.
Go! Ready, break! Hey!
Looking for this?
Man, is he a piece of work.
What was that?
Christopher did it.
Did not.
Did too.
Did not.
Did too.
Did not.
Hold it.
Now, during the summer, we're going to work
hard.
During the summer, we're going to get
strong.
During the summer, we're going to grow
strong.
Then in the fall, we're going to be
big.
All right.
Okay. Hello, Christopher.
Hi, Dad.
I'm serious.
All right. What's the problem now?
Every time something's broken, he's standing next to it. Every time something's spilled, he's standing in it.
He's a born quarterback. I'll talk to him.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Dad. Dad, look what I can do.
Great. You'll be a cheerleader yet.
I don't want to be a cheerleader.
Sure you do.
Thanks.
Hmm. You better get a move on, honey. I don't want to be late for my big night. Oh, there are my folks. Come on, kids.
Hello?
Anybody home?
Did you bring it, Teddy?
Say hello first.
Hello, did you bring it in here?
Hi, Dad.
Hey, that's yours, and that's
That's what I wanted.
Oh, well,
nothing for me.
Say hello first. Well, there's a pineapple upside down cake in the camper.
No banana cream pie?
It was delicious.
You dog.
Can we clean the camper?
Yeah, all right. Go ahead, but don't turn on the TV.
Do what Grandpa says now. Hey, you guys better hurry. You know, we got this thing at 7:30.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this thing.
Yeah.
You hear that, Mother? They're going to make a man of the year, and he's calling it this thing.
Oh, son, we are so proud of you. Hi.
Hi, Patricia.
Hello, darling.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, hi, Pat. How are you?
We set the boys' room for you.
No need to, Pat. We're going to be spending the next 6 weeks in this thing, so we might as well start getting used to it tonight. Mother?
Couple beers?
Ah, good deal. Okay. Listen, Mother, why don't you help Patricia fix the kids' supper, huh, so we can get the show on the road.
Well, let's go.
Of course, dear. Yeah. You boys go right ahead.
Good.
You're going to spend 6 weeks in the camp?
Oh, my.
After 40 years, what can go wrong?
Well, Pat, how have you been?
Wonderful. It's wonderful. Well, I just don't have anything to wear.
I thought you were going to buy a new dress.
So did I. But by the time I got Robert's shoes and Christopher's new jeans and picked up Ginny at ballet school, I'd run out of time and money.
What about that red dress? You look great in that.
I haven't been able to wear that red dress in 3 years.
Hmm? Oh. Hey, how do I look?
Fine, wonderful.
Can't even see.
Who has to see? You always look fine and wonderful.
Thanks, honey. How long ago did I buy this suit? 10 years? Fits like the day I bought it.
Bob, could you and your suit go downstairs and see what that crash was all about?
Hmm? Oh, yeah, sure. Looks a little tight, honey.
Thanks.
Better hurry.
Bob? Bob, can I get you something?
Not
money, we know. Yeah. Dan, you remember Herman Ohm, our principal?
How do you do?
Oh, likewise, I'm sure.
Well, you must be very proud of this young man.
I haven't been proud of this lad for so long, I'm beginning to take it for granted.
Pat?
Pat?
Peter's wine.
Yes.
You're so lucky.
Thank you.
What a wonderful man. You must be very happy.
Yes, thanks.
I'm Mrs. Walt Johnson. Walt Johnson's wife? Oh. I can tell by the look on your face, you don't know who Walt Johnson is.
Sorry.
Well, that's him over there.
Oh,
I lost my name tag. Now I don't know who I am. You know who you are? Bob Peters.
Right.
You have it. Another name. A name of your very own.
Pat.
Good for you. I like you. Bob Peters' wife, Pat.
Excuse me.
By gar, it's Walt Johnson in the flesh.
You must be Bob Peters' wife, huh?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Come on.
Well, why don't we say hello to Pat?
Why don't we talk about the uniform?
I'd rather say hello to Pat. Hi, Pat.
Hi, Herman.
Oh.
Hello, Traitor.
Traitor? Oh, I suppose you like me to have my baby on my lunch hour.
No, as a matter of fact, on my lunch hour. That way I would never have to be in that place without you.
Oh, Herman, just stop with the guilt. Just find someone.
Oh, sure, just like that. Someone that knows me, someone that knows the school. Pat.
What?
Pat?
Yeah, Pat. You remember her, the girl that put you through grad school, working as a secretary, and a darn good one?
That was a long time ago.
Well, it's just like riding a bicycle.
Oh, come on, Herman. Pat has no time.
It's only for the summer, so what do you say?
Oh!
Testing, testing, testing. Can everybody hear me out there? Okay, okay, okay. First off, why don't we give a big hand to the chef's de cuisine here at Tetweiler's Motor Inn. What do you say, gang, huh? Hey! Very good, good. That was a very, very nice Salisbury steak entree, and the service was fine, as usual. Just what we come to expect here. Thank you, girls. Good. Okay. Now, down to business. Every year, we give this award. But never before, to my recollection, have we had a more deserving recipient. Teacher of the Year, CIF Coach of the Year, Marine Corps veteran, civic activist who's, well, the list goes on and on. But lastly, it ends with what Bob considers first, his family. As a devoted father and husband, Bob typifies what the American male is and can be. So, Coach Bob Peters, it gives me great pleasure to present to a man's man, the Chamber of Commerce Man of the Year Award. There it is. Come on up, everybody.
I'm pleased. And so I'll just say thank you all. And I'd just like to say that I'm real happy that my folks to be here to share this. Come on, Mom, stand up. And before I go, I'd just like to say that I owe a lot of this and wish to share it. My wonderful wife, Pat.
Hold on, wait a minute. Hold it, keep it down. Wait a minute now. Wait a minute. We anticipated this, Bob. Can I get serious for just a minute? When the man of the house is out there all day long in the trenches, every day, day in, day out, he comes home at night. His castle. Who do you think is there keeping the home fires burning? The little woman. Knowing that behind us all is our better half and that without him we'd be nothing, we'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge Bob's little Pat. Here it is, folks. Hold it, hold it. Wait a minute now. Says, world's best wife.
Here, Patty, say a few words. Tell us how you're doing. Here you go.
All of us at Channel 5 want to add our good wishes to Coach Peters. And remember, we will be carrying the Cougars games right here come fall.
Why, boy. What a night, huh? Very sure. I'm proud of you, Bobby.
Thanks, Dad.
We're proud of both of you. Oh, of course.
Both you and Patty.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Well, come on, Mother. I've hit the sack. I want to get an early start in the morning. And look, don't you two bother to get up and see us off. We'll say our goodbyes now. We'll see you in about 6 weeks.
Have a great trip.
Thanks.
I'm really glad that you were here for this.
Oh, no. We wouldn't have missed it. We wouldn't have missed it for the world, would we, Mother?
Oh, not for the world.
Chop.
You children are so lucky.
Yeah, lucky. Luck had nothing to do with it. This is work, hard work. These two kids, they gave all they had, and then they got it all back. American dream, huh?
Now, yes. You be careful driving.
I'll worry, we will.
Night.
Saturday night.
Night-night.
You know, they're right. We are the American dream.
26,000 Americans.
I got an A in creative speaking. I gave this great speech once my freshman year. They all clapped.
What do you say we take the American dream upstairs?
It was on the history of the Mississippi Delta. They really loved me, and tonight I just stood there.
You look great.
I looked frightened.
It's your first time on TV. You're just a little shy.
I'm shy, all right. I'm shy of personality and identity.
Oh, come on, Pat. You're not going to spoil my big evening with some silly little thing.
Did you hear what I said?
You couldn't make a speech. So what?
Everybody thought you were cute.
I don't want to be cute.
It's too late, honey. You already are.
You're not listening to me. Nobody listens to me, because I have nothing to say.
Well, things must have been really bad in General Hospital today.
I'm trying to tell you something. Don't you see that Herman asked you if I could have a job?
He didn't ask me. We were discussing it.
Right. You were discussing it. I was not discussing it.
Well, what's the difference? There's nothing to discuss.
I want to discuss that.
What?
That you think my getting a job is so totally out of the question that we can't even talk about it.
Well, we can talk about it. If you want to be realistic, take a look around you. Can you imagine what would happen if you got a job?
I might start feeling like me, instead of Bob Peters' wife or the kid's mother.
That's who you are.
That's a part of me, Bob, but there's this other part inside that's gone, and I didn't even realize it.
Pat, this is crazy. You can't even take care of this place now. Well, I come home, it looks like a bomb hit it. Look, dinner's late, kids are a mess. Pat, believe me, the last thing in the world you need is a job.
You're wrong, Bob. I think the first thing I need is a job. And I'm going to call Herman in the morning, and I'm going to tell him.
Pat, come back here. Let's discuss this.
Consider it discussed.
Pat? Pat? Morning. Still mad at me? Thought so. Well, I want you to know I was thinking about what you said last night, and I understand.
You do?
Meet me for a cup of coffee, and I'll tell you about it.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Okay, so tell me about it.
Well, I was thinking about our conversation last night. And I can understand that you're feeling a bit,
confined.
No.
Yes, Bob, confined.
Okay, confined. I was thinking, frustrated.
That too.
Okay. You're feeling confined and frustrated. I mean, with the kids, house, the cooking, and the cleaning.
And the washing and ironing and the carpools.
Right. That too. All that stuff. Anyway, you never seem to be able to get out from under. I mean, when was the last time you had an afternoon to yourself?
I think it was 1973.
See? It's not good, Pat.
You do understand.
I told you I understand, and I want to help to make it better.
You do?
Mm-hmm. Now, I've been sitting around watching you trying to run this house. Kind of hung back. But the truth is, Pat, I see a lot of ways where with a little organization, you could have plenty of free time.
Oh.
Sure. You could go to class. You could play some tennis.
Tennis?
Yeah, you like tennis.
So you think I want to play tennis?
My job is to find you the free time. You do with it what you want.
Thanks. Nice to know you understand.
Hey, when I'm in the middle of a game, sometimes I'm so close to things, I can miss a lot of things that are obvious. That's why I have that guy up in the booth talking to me on that headset. He's detached. He's got an overview, and he can see a lot of things that I miss.
And you have this overview of how I should run the house.
Just some suggestions. Now, I'm going to write them down on a piece of paper this afternoon, and we'll talk about it tonight, and you see if it doesn't make a difference.
Can't wait.
I gotta run. I love you.
Okay.
Don't strain yourself. Please, I'm very depressed.
School psychologist depressed?
Didn't you ever drop a pass?
What's wrong?
Herman just told me that because of cutbacks, my summer counseling job is out.
That's terrible.
I hope every kid in this town between the ages of 14 and 17 goes wacky on July 1st, and they can't find me because I'm not digging somebody's cesspool.
Hey, I'm sorry.
Hey, save your sympathy for yourself. They may be cutting driver's ed, too.
No way. Had that job for 5 years.
Yeah, just in case, I'll save you a shovel. A nice gold-plated one for the man of the year.
Thank you.
Sure. It was a great dinner last night.
Yeah. It was kind of terrific, wasn't it?
Pat seemed a little upset.
You noticed that, huh?
My business. You guys having a little problem?
No, nothing like that. She's just feeling kind of...
Confined?
How'd you know?
A lot of that going around.
I know that, but I didn't expect it from Pat. Pat, well... just Pat.
I didn't expect it from Ruthie either. You know Ruthie. She's... gone.
Well, it's not that serious. Pat and I had a little talk this morning. Everything's okay.
You never know. Remember Freud's dying words. Good grief, good grief. What do women want?
Those were Freud's dying words?
Just before his wife shot him.
Take a little bite of that and give Fat like the rest of us.
Thank you, Herman. Say, I spoke to Fred. It's too bad.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry about that.
What about driver's ed?
Well, to tell you the truth, that looks pretty shaky, too.
Shaky?
So it's a good thing that Pat took the job.
Pat what?
Well, didn't the two of you talk that over?
Yeah. Yeah. Sure. Yeah.
But we talked it over.
No, you talked it over. I wasn't through talking.
Okay, talk, but try not to mention tennis.
Well, I thought everything was fine this morning. We talked. I even made up a list. I have it right here. 10 terrific suggestions.
Shouldn't they be on a stone tablet?
I don't understand this, Pat. What's got into you?
It's very simple. I need to work.
Well, what about the kids?
Daycare.
I don't want my kids in daycare.
Then we'll have Mrs. Olson come in.
Mrs. Olson is 904 years old.
Then we'll get some professional help.
Well, that costs money.
I've got a job.
Welcome.
Thanks.
Well, what shall we start with? A few laps around the desk or just a little dictation? Why don't you get settled first, huh? Then come on in. Okay?
Okay, thanks. Hi, Pat.
Hi.
Welcome to the world of the working.
Thanks.
Nervous.
Yeah.
That wasn't a question. That was an observation.
Oh, it shows, huh?
Relax. You'll be just fine. And if you need anything, holler.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, Pat, yeah, come in. I just want to dictate a short little letter before I go down to the board and take my ration of heat for the week. Then you can type it up, and I'll sign it when I get back, okay?
Okay.
All right, this would go to Mr. C.D. Green, Acme Publishing, Vincennes, Indiana, blah, blah, blah. The address should be on file. Dear Mr. Green, pursuing our telephone conversation, May 16th, the shipment of the... What have we got?
Mr. Indiana.
We are a little rusty, aren't we?
Sorry, Herman.
That's all right. Look, we won't do this now. I'll dictate it when I come back, and I'm not in such a rush, okay?
Oh, thanks, Herman.
It's all right. Just relax, huh?
Oh, I misspelled Indiana.
Herman?
Oh, hi, Bob.
How's Pat doing?
Slow, but unsure. Now she's going to be fine.
Good.
Listen, Bob, I hate to tell you this, but it is definite. There's not going to be any driver's ed this summer. And I'm sorry.
I wait for Mrs. Peters.
No, that's okay. I'll handle it.
Okay.
Can you make it okay?
Yes, you'll help me.
Ah, there we go. Take it easy.
Thank you. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, okay.
Bye, Mrs. Olsen.
Now, watch your step now. Don't step on any of his toys.
Voila. To Mr. C.D. Green.
That is terrific.
Oh, good.
You are not fired.
Oh, good. Thanks, Herman.
Send that out.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Hi.
We're hungry.
Well, did it ever occur to anybody to do anything about that?
Yeah, if you weren't home in 10 minutes, we were going to go out to dinner.
Great.
Where are you going?
I have 10 minutes to freshen up for dinner.
Hey, Pat!
Knock it off!
Okay, you knock it off, young man. What's the matter with him?
He's just tired.
Baby!
Jenny, stop teasing.
He's teasing me!
Well, then stop listening. Come on.
Let's go.
I want to watch TV.
The TV is sleeping. Everybody upstairs. Night-night.
Come on, move it, baby.
Stop calling me baby.
All right.
You both got babies.
Oh, yeah. I'll be back to tuck you in a minute. And don't forget to brush your teeth. Want a cup of coffee?
No, thanks. Pat, this isn't going to work. House is a disaster. No dinner.
It's one day.
I think that's all Mrs. Olsen had in it.
Well, then I'll hire a housekeeper.
How much will that cost?
$100 a week, maybe more.
Not on your salary.
My job is not about money.
It is now. The council drives education.
Oh, you're kidding.
The unemployment office said that things weren't very encouraging.
They said there wasn't much available, and I was overqualified.
What are we going to do?
I don't know. It's going to be tight. $100 a week, I have half a mind to take care of this place.
Have half a mind to want to.
Oh, come on, Pat. Doesn't take that much to run this place.
You have no idea what it takes to run this house.
If you looked at my list of suggestions, you know I have a very good idea of what it takes to run this house.
Your overview?
Laugh if you want. But it takes the same thing it takes to do anything well. Organization. Which, as we both know, darling, is not your strong suit.
Bob, this house is not a game. It's not a bunch of X's and O's on a blackboard that go where you tell them to. It's a darn tough job.
Job?
Yeah, job. One which I think you were underqualified for.
I can do this job in my sleep.
Yeah, well, that's the best way to do it. It's boring and lonely and dull. You need a high tolerance for frustration and a little or no ego, which, as we know, darling, is not your strong suit.
It's obvious you take no pride in it.
Bob, to a housewife, pride is something that comes in a bottle and polishes the floor.
Pride is also something that comes from a job well done.
That's right. And the trouble with this job is that it's never done. Excuse me. I'm going to bed. I've had a hard day at the office.
Turning point in human relations.
Oh, Bob, it's almost 3 o'clock.
It's the dawn of a new era, which is coincidentally spelled E-R-A.
Huh?
Behold, a motherhood contract.
What?
My original suggestions, with a few additions, set down in a document which will probably go down in history next to the Magna Carta. Motherhood contract. I, Bob Peters, will switch roles for a period dating from June 20th day until August 27th. In so doing, indicate to you and any interested party that the real difficulty of motherhood and housewifery is that those duties are traditionally performed by an essentially incompetent sex, namely, the weaker one. One, child care. I shall oversee the rearing, training, health, and activities, both educational and recreational, of our three children, Christopher, Robert, and Jennifer.
I know their names.
Two, chores. I shall prepare nutritious meals and snacks of all nations. I shall maintain the cleanliness of the household, vacuuming, mopping, windows, simple chores that now never seem to get done, laundry, and yes, even ironing. Three, money management. The money saved from this new management will go into a fund for quality time activities for the family, G-rated films, trips to the zoo, etc.
Bob.
Four, I shall...
Bob.
What?
This is ridiculous.
It's perfect. It gives us a chance to get through the summer on your salary, and it gives me an opportunity to show you how to run this house.
Of all the arrogance...
Not arrogance. Confidence.
Bob, burn it.
Burn it? I'll publish it.
Yeah? And what are you going to do when you find out you're wrong?
If I'm wrong.
When?
That unlikely case, I'll make a public disclosure.
Oh, you're going to march down Main Street with a brass band apologizing?
I think you're afraid I'm right.
When do you intend to start?
I've started.
You're on.
Thank you.
kids are downstairs and they want breakfast.
Huh? Well, no way.
If I were you, I'd hurry up and get down there before they lay waste to that part of the house.
I don't tend to handle this with the same aura of panic that characterized your...
Sit down. Everything's gonna be okay. Let's watch out for the glass. Sit down. No problems. Daddy's in charge.
Where's Mommy?
Mommy's going off to work. Daddy's gonna look after things for a while.
Do you know what you're doing?
Of course I know what I'm doing.
Mommy, we want breakfast.
I know what I'm doing.
But she's the mommy.
Yes, but Mommy has a job and Daddy's going to do Mommy's other job.
What's your other job? Taking care of us.
Right.
What if something happens to us?
Now, wait a minute. Divide these up. Food. Cereal. Wholesome food from the grain groups. Milk. Rich in calcium and vitamin D. Use them spoon. Eat them. Cereal. Bingo. Breakfast.
I don't like this kind of cereal. I like...
You'll eat what's put in front of you, young man. When I was your age, we ate what was put in front of us. No ifs, ands, or buts. And we were happy to have it. Christopher. Clean that up. Christopher! Christopher, Daddy will show you how to clean that up.
Well, have a nice day.
After breakfast, I will show you how to make your beds with hospital corners. This is official Marine Corps procedure. Done properly, you should be able to bounce a quarter. Thank you. Now you try it.
Is he kidding?
Coffee break. Read the paper.
We're hungry.
You just had breakfast. 1 o'clock.
We want lunch.
How'd you get so dirty? There's no mud out there. Where's the mud?
We made it.
Well, go get cleaned up. Not there.
Then where?
There. But be neat. Okay, they're ready. Come and get it. Robert, medium. Jennifer, rare. And how are you today, sir?
I think well done.
Okay. Well done. And then Coach Bob. Who's he?
He's Timmy.
Thank you.
It's incredible. You do this every day?
Only on special occasions.
What's today?
It's our first lunch together.
Oh.
And tomorrow will be our second, and there's a third, and our fourth, and our...
Watch this, you guys. I'm gonna do a cannonball.
Robert, Timmy, stay out of the pool.
Oh, come on, Dad.
Sweep and vacuum all rooms as necessary. Not necessary.
Hi, Dad.
Carry on.
You know who likes
horses? That's right.
I'll tell you.
That's
who likes
good.
Horses. The guy at the
very
big
good.
Store. He'll
okay.
Make some money. They gotta get refills for these, you know.
Hey, excuse me. The new department of senior citizens.
This is better for you.
Tentative 13-0 approval by the city council. Because of the enthusiastic primary support, next week is virtually assured. The political clout of the seniors was apparent as they held.
Hi, guys.
Marched to the city hall about 400.
Hi, honey.
Hi. About a soda.
Sure.
Turn down the TV, kids. Mommy's had a hard day. Each council member rose to make a
speech, noting the large. How about some red wine? I opened it for dinner. I know how you like it with steak and salad. I fed the kids early. I thought, you know, just the two of us?
Fine.
What's going on here? I don't know. Me neither.
So you're having more broccoli?
Yes.
How is it?
How is what?
Broccoli.
It's the best I ever had.
And I bet you've had a lot of broccoli. And the potatoes.
Good. I see you boiled them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, right to sleep, guys. Big day tomorrow.
Good night, Dad.
Good night.
Night.
Good night. Not too late, honey.
Dad? I want to give you some good advice.
Okay.
Those two guys across the hall kill you if you give them an inch. I know them.
Thanks.
Dad, You didn't do bad today for someone who doesn't know what they're doing.
Thanks.
Well, whatever. It's nice to have you around.
Nice to have you around, Pumpkin. Thank you.
I guess, the traditional time for marriages. Why is that? Why do most people like to get to be a junior bride?
I don't know where that came from. And somebody in our audience will know.
Anybody know the history of that?
School's out.
School's out?
School's out.
One down, 69 to go.
How about some coffee?
Love it. I'm going to make some coffee.
Great.
Here is a new book called The New Woman's Guide to Getting Married.
Ready, Daddy? Coming up.
Care for a short stack, honey?
No, thanks. Just coffee.
Why don't you just take your dog home,
Okay, come on, you guys. Let's go and play.
Where are you going?
To play.
Yeah, but who's going to supervise this play period? Lunch! I was just trying to get a little jump on things.
Why don't you get up at 3? You could paint the den.
Just that breakfast gets a little hectic.
You think it's a game?
No, honey.
Yes, honey. And you're out to win, to show that it's easy, to prove that you're better at it than me.
That's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous, all right, because if you keep this up, Bob, you're not going to make it, and we can't afford that. So just forget about the candlelight dinners and save every bit of energy you can, because you're going to need it. Believe me.
What's wrong?
I never thought I'd miss green vegetables.
Well, Coach, if you're looking for a balanced diet, my recipe should do it.
Thank you, Mrs. Sousa. I knew you'd help.
You opening a camp or something?
No, it's for my family.
Well, they'd better have big appetites. Those are all for 1,000 servings.
That's okay. I'll just have to break them down.
What's all this about?
Oh, I'm taking care of the house for the summer.
Why?
Well, it just sort of happened.
I'm sorry.
Any
helpful hints?
Hints? Yeah. If it don't pour, dip it.
Hey, kid, what kind of juice do you want?
Cranberry!
Don't stand up in the car, Chris.
All right.
143.27.
143.27?
Yes.
For what?
That's not bad.
It isn't?
No.
But I have a budget. Anybody want to buy some bananas?
I'm hungry.
Oh, tonight's Chef Robert is something special. Hungarian goulash.
Sounds yucky.
Well, that's with noodles.
Okay.
Yeah, Robert, make yourself useful. Here you go. Attaboy, thanks. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh. Oh.
Farmers, allowing them to complete Texaco Dam, said they would consider building a toxic waste dump in the area if they could coax industry there. An agency spokesman first indicated that the waste dump was not a serious proposal. But a
welcome.
Dated May 20th, stated otherwise. And a memo PVA had...
Aren't you having any?
No, kind of tired.
Your cookies?
Yeah.
Not bad.
It's a mix.
I know.
Look, about this morning, you said... Well, there were many things that... But perhaps I...
Thanks.
Yeah. Well, I just wanted to tell you. And there's another thing.
You're giving me the keys to your Mustang?
Loan it. You can't do this job without the tool. Good night.
Maybe I'll come up with you.
To be honest, I really am kind of tired. Okay, kids, when you're finished, I want you to clean up your dishes and get dressed.
We can't.
Why not?
We don't have any clothes. You take them all the time and never wash them and never give them back.
The laundry. I've forgotten to do the laundry. I'll never catch up.
Do you think he knows how to do the laundry?
Yeah.
okay, Chief. Just relax. Everything's going to be okay.
I don't think so. You used too much soap.
Well, that makes things cleaner.
Why is it pink?
What?
Everything.
You go in. I'll handle this.
What happened to Mommy's sweater?
That's Mommy's sweater? That's Mommy's sweater.
I'm telling.
You say a word to anyone, I'm not going to let you watch television until you're 97 years old. Got it?
Got it.
Kind of dragon, aren't you?
Yeah, but you ought to taste my pot roast.
Pot roast?
Mrs. Zusoff's recipe.
Spare me.
You don't know what you're missing.
How's it going?
2 weeks, 4 days, 6 hours.
Not bad, huh?
It's the boredom. It's like always going to practice. No matter how good you get, you just keep practicing. There's no Saturday, there's no game. There's no place to see how really good you are.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
What?
Freud's answer to what women want. A place to find out how good they really are.
Hello, Pat Peters.
Hi, Mom.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. Just wanted to say hi.
Oh, hi, honey. How's it going?
It's different.
I bet.
Well, I'll see you.
I love you.
I love you too, Mommy. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Tell me what's going on here, Nola.
What do you mean?
What was all that on the phone?
I told you I was asleep. You woke me up from a dream.
You didn't sound like you were asleep. Who did you think was calling you?
Who knows? It was a nightmare.
Don't make jokes, Nola. Just tell me, who were you expecting when I called you on the phone?
I don't know what you're talking about, Billy.
What's his name, Nola?
Too busy.
Oh, come on, Dad. You're never any fun.
Come on, Dad.
Where's Jennifer? Where's Jennifer? Hi, Jimmy. Okay, hold it. Everybody out.
Help!
too, Robert.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
Wet.
What happened?
I was just in the pool with the kids.
Oh, leisure time.
More of an emotional release. What's up?
Some of the girls are going out to dinner tonight. It's Linda's 40th birthday.
Yeah?
Well, so I sort of thought maybe I might go along. You know, sort of an emotional release.
Uh-huh.
So I guess I won't be home for dinner.
Huh.
Well, see you later.
Yeah, have fun.
Thanks. Bye.
So long.
Round two, Planter's punch without the punch. Grasshopper, slow gin, fizz, and a zombie.
Pat, relax.
I'm relaxed.
You keep checking every 5 minutes.
Wrong. Last time I checked was 10 minutes.
See?
Telling you, Ralph, I think we should give it a shot. Margaret's out of town for 2 weeks. I've got the house to myself. I mean, they're great.
Huh? It just seems so strange to be doing this.
But fun.
Oh, yes, fun. But strange.
How is he holding up?
Oh, he's okay. Sometimes he's better than okay. Beginning to wonder if maybe he's right about the organization.
Stop wondering. Anyone can do it for a month.
5 weeks.
So what? It's a lifetime that gets you.
I know, but it just feels so unnatural. I want to help.
Pat. Was it unnatural while you did everything? And he just sat there? Me man, you woman. Cook food, wash shorts, come bed.
Why, Linda, have you been seeing my husband?
Good for you.
Say, girls, what are you all doing out alone?
Alone? We're not alone. We're all together.
Well, excuse me.
Is that a zombie?
He just left.
Okay, Chief. Night, guys.
Good night, Ann.
Good night.
Night.
Pat.
Been drinking.
So have I. Very nice, thank you.
What?
I had a very nice time.
I didn't ask.
I know. I thought I'd tell you anyway.
Thinking of growing a beard?
What?
Well, you want so badly to be a man. Working, staying out all hours, coming home drunk?
I am not drunk, and I have no desire to be a man.
Then what do you want to be?
Just what I am.
What's that?
Daddy. Daddy.
Coming, honey.
Would you fill it up, please? Thanks.
How's Susie Homemaker? I haven't seen him in a while.
Oh, he's fine. Great.
How about you? You enjoy working?
Oh, I love it.
So he's fine and great and you love it?
Uh-huh.
I'd be less than a good psychologist if I didn't notice this is not a happy face.
I don't know, Fred. Just all seems kind of strange.
Well, you know, you two guys are kind of writing a book on this thing. At this point, you're hardly the typical American family.
Maybe that's what scares me.
Well, don't let it, because that's the place I get all my patients.
Thanks, Fred.
Right.
Chris, that box of Odie's, okay?
Daddy packed some great stuff for you. I got pickles, some potato salad.
Yum.
And your very favorite, bologna and peanut butter sandwiches. What's the matter?
Guys haven't said a word all day. This is supposed to be fun.
What is it?
Robert said that you're taking his letter to tell us that you're making a divorce.
Divorce?
What?
Robert, where did you get that? Why would we do that?
Kenny Birnbaum's parents took him to Disneyland to tell him.
Oh. Now, wait a minute. Wait just one moment. Come here, little lady. We brought you here because we wanted to have fun.
Right.
We brought you here because we love you.
Really?
Absolutely. Really and truly.
Do you love Mommy?
Of course I love Mommy. Mommy loves me.
Told ya.
They're really something, aren't they?
You don't have to tell me.
Guess not. It's amazing how much you can get to love someone just from washing their socks.
I think it's the best way.
You know, sometimes I can look at Robert's T-shirt and I can tell his whole day. Jelly in the morning, mustard at lunch.
Yeah, he's a walking menu.
Well, nothing else. It's a good way to get to know my kids.
And them getting to know you.
At this point, I don't even know me.
That's funny. I feel like I'm just beginning to know me.
Now, come on. Go ahead.
Is he
going to
be okay?
This is going to be fine as long as you stop feeding a peanut butter.
Well,
yes.
Daddy,
you
likes
peanut
butter.
Well, then leave out the pickles.
That's
okay. Watch
your
toes. Watch your nose. Here we go.
Hey, I'm hungry.
Stay out of the back, Robert.
Daddy, I'm sitting down here.
No, no, you sit here. Let Missy sit down where
Can
she
I
is.
Can I sit back there?
No, please, sit here.
But it's lonesome.
Oh, butter, I forgot the butter.
Beautiful.
Quiet, quiet.
spell?
Quiet.
Q.
U.
Y.
I don't mean.
Who you going to spell?
Quiet! I don't want to spell quiet. I don't want to say quiet. I want to hear quiet.
Daddy!
Quiet.
Dad.
Quiet. I don't believe this.
Oh, boy, he's just like Chips.
Now, everybody, just stay calm, hmm?
What did you do wrong, Daddy?
Nothing. Officer?
You have your license, sir?
Yeah. What's wrong?
You went through that stop sign.
Oh? I didn't even see it. I thought the boys were fighting, you know how kids are.
I'm not married.
Oh, well, that's how kids are. I'm late with lunch. Ton of ironing. I haven't even made the beds yet. Got the butter.
Have you been drinking?
Quiet!
Drinking. I haven't even had coffee yet.
Bob Peters.
Yeah.
Coach Peters?
Right.
You're kidding. My kid brother's on your team. Richie Doyle.
Richie? Oh, good kid. A lot of heart, a lot of drive, yeah. It's gonna work well off the shotgun.
Oh, you're going with a shotgun.
Third down, a lot of yardage.
Daddy, I have to go to the bathroom.
All right, honey. Son.
Take it easy, Coach.
Aren't you gonna get a ticket?
Robert.
I'll tell Richie I saw you.
Yeah, tell him to stay tough.
Daddy?
Right.
This is pretty.
Hmm?
Where is this?
That's Banff.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah. Oh, well, the whole trip was beautiful as far as that goes. But I want to tell you one thing. What a great treat it is just to sit down at a real dining room table and eat a real home-cooked meal again.
Yeah. After a while, you really get to hate the taste of charcoal.
Casserole was really just delicious, Patricia.
Bob made it.
Oh, Bob. Yeah. Yeah, it was really wonderful, son.
Nothing.
No, really, Robert, it was wonderful. Well, you know that some of the best chefs in the world are men.
Absolutely. Absolutely. There's nothing wrong, you know, man cooking. But...
Certainly not.
Hey, Bobby, what do you say we get a couple of beers, go out in the backyard, and I'll tell you a couple of real great fishing stories. Huh?
Can we drink them in the kitchen, Dad? Got to do the dishes.
By the kitchen? Sure.
Sure,
that'd be great.
Well, can I do a couple of loads in your washer?
Sure. Bring them in, Mom. I got to run a few things through the wash myself.
You do the laundry?
And windows.
Oh, no, it was very interesting. Can't wait to go to sleep in my own bed tomorrow.
My bed. What's the matter?
Well, I just think we should be doing something.
We are. We're talking. Would you like some more coffee?
Oh, no, no, thanks.
Well, I would.
You getting it?
Yeah.
Then I would. I just didn't want to bother Robert. He looks so tired.
Mother, it's okay. He wanted to do this.
The fish jumped right into the boat.
So, how you guys doing?
Hey, Patty. Great. Doing just great. How are your gals doing?
Oh, fine.
They caught a 4-pound cutthroat.
Ah, great!
Yeah.
Sounds like you had a great vacation.
Oh, we did. We did. It was great. Great. We had a really great trip. Yeah. Okay, and that was the fish stories. Robert, what the hell is going on here?
Tell you the truth?
not so sure myself.
Well, I know, and things are changing. We saw it on the trip. Nothing's like it used to be.
That's for sure.
Tell you one thing, though. I'm glad I'm my age, not yours. Because I'm not too sure I could handle what's coming up.
Not coming. It's already here.
Bobby. You're still going to coach the team, though, aren't you?
Well, the softest, smoothest hands in town.
Bob, how you doing?
Great.
You're the one who always hates to be late.
I'll be with you in a second.
Lady, for my money, you're making a big mistake. And I said, yeah, but this is my money, so wrap it up.
Can I help you?
Doubt it.
It was a madhouse. The kids were screaming.
Beer.
The plumber turned off all the water in the house. The worst thing is, I miss the end of days of our lives. What happened?
Don't know. I had to take Eric to the orthodontist. His braces snapped.
Oh. Mrs. Matuzak's husband came back.
What?
Mrs. Matuzak's husband came back.
But he's dead.
No, he had amnesia. He still doesn't remember everything, but he remembered the house and just rang the bell.
You must be Pat Peter's husband.
That's me.
Well, I just think it's wonderful what you and Pat are doing.
Make that a martini. Double.
What does it say?
I don't know. All those lines, and the red thing comes and goes.
Yeah, it does. Maybe we should try again.
Bob, could you go see what Missy's barking about?
I don't hear her barking.
Must be something out in the backyard.
Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Why is everybody taking my temperature?
Well, we'll just keep this one between the two of us, okay? One more. Hello, Pat Peters. Hi.
I'm worried about Jenny.
Oh, it's just a little cold coming on. Just keep her warm.
Well, the other kids. If it spreads.
Honey, if you're that worried about it, take her over to see Dr. Marshall. I really gotta run, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye. Jenny!
Serious?
Oh, no, I don't think so. Just a little cold.
It's okay if you want to go.
No thanks, Herman. Bob can handle it. It's just a couple more weeks.
Not necessarily.
What?
I'd like you to stay, Pat, after Marion comes back.
You mean a real job?
Hey, you've been doing a real job, and a terrific job at that. I'd say more, but I'm afraid you might ask for a raise.
A raise?
That's out of the question. Well, maybe $25 a week. What do you say?
I don't know.
What do you think about it?
We're over at the Matterhorn. What a sight.
And what a sound.
Oh, help.
Balloon has nicked himself in a rocky crag, gas seeping out with an ominous hiss.
More later, I hope.
Try it.
Not bad.
Juice or milk?
Juice. Milk. No, I mean milk.
To see ya. Glad to see ya. Hey, would you like a sandwich? Here you go. How about a cold beer to go with that?
Thanks.
Well, hey, how you doing?
Okay.
You like sports?
No.
Nice day. Hot enough for you?
Yeah.
That's what gas station attendants say all the time. Check the water, the oil, hot enough for you.
Right.
Well, I guess I better get you that beer.
Okay, thanks.
Then after college, I had a shot at the pros. Nothing important, you understand. Say, what time is it?
It's after 4.
It's my birthday. My wife's taking me out. I have a million things to do. Say, you don't mind if I,
I don't mind at all, Mr. Peters.
How much did you say that was?
87.50.
87.50. Forgot the 50 cents. There we go. 50. Very good. Now you be sure to come to a lot of games, you hear?
Okay.
Oh, this has been a pleasure. A real pleasure. Uh-huh. Don't forget to take out a few ads.
Thanks.
Okay?
Yeah.
Have a good day now.
Right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So long.
So long.
Thanks again. Christopher. I'll give you just 2 seconds to clean that off. You just wait till your mother gets home.
I am home.
What's going on here? Oh, why?
Why? Pick a reason. Any reason. I spend a lot of time every day cleaning up after him or trying to find out where he is. I clean up a room, they dirty it. I make a meal, and they wear it. Everybody has needs. Everybody has wants. What about me? What about my needs? I'll tell you about my needs. It's over. 68 days. I quit.
Bob, wait.
What for? And I told you so. You win, I lose. Congratulations. I gotta get out of here.
Daddy coming back?
Of course. He's just upset. No, Fred, everything's all right. I just thought maybe you might have seen him at the gym or something. Okay, bye. Things came together and started looking pretty big.
Who's going to take care of us now?
Mommy. Same as always. Hello?
Mrs. Peters?
Yes?
Your husband asked me to call.
Is he all right?
Oh, fine, really. He just wants you to turn on the Channel 5 news.
Why? What happened?
Nothing really. He just wants to make sure you're watching. Sorry. I have to run. Bye.
Bye.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
You don't want to watch the news.
Dodgers are at it again. That's sports except for a guest. Coach Bob Peters of the Cougars. Now, he's not here to talk about football,
Daddy,
but he has asked
Daddy,
for some
Daddy's
time.
Daddy's going to be on TV. Daddy.
Bob Peters asked for something. He gets it. Bob?
Thanks, Tom. Hi, sports fans. Like a lot of you guys out there, I've spent my life feeling I was pretty tough. Playing ball, fighting war, and just trying to make it as a man. Pretty rough world. But this summer, I found out what tough really is. I took care of the house while my wife went to work. I thought it would be a piece of cake. But I'm here tonight to eat some crow. I'm here tonight to proclaim respect for the housewife, a creature of uncommon strength and importance. Running a home and parenting are exhausting and totally time-consuming and can't be taken care of by one person unless that person is willing to sacrifice themselves at great expense to the heart and spirit. With this in mind, I concede that I failed in a contract with my wife. I failed her as a husband and as a friend. I will not fail again. She's my partner. We are in this all together. Pat, I am sorry. Pat, if you're watching, I love you very much.
Yeah, this phone hasn't stopped ringing for over an hour. Everybody in town must have seen it. Yeah, it was me. Okay, thanks for calling. Okay, bye, Joan. Say hi to Walt.
Is Daddy famous?
Well, let's just say he's extremely popular. Hello? Hi, Herman. Yeah, it was. Yes, he is. No, I had no idea. Somebody from the studio called. Yes, I feel terrific. What? Are you kidding? I'll be in at 8:30 as usual.
I'm here, Mrs. Peters. Brass band and all.
Night-night.
Night, Jen.
Night-night.
Night.
Gentlemen.
Good night. Night, guys.
Good night.
Want some coffee?
Good idea. Your coffee or mine?
How about a little bit of both?
Sounds